for the National Wrestling Alliance World Heavyweight Title. First of all, making his way to ringside, the challenger, weighs in at 231 pounds. Here is the Bullet. His way to ringside, the pinnacle of the National Wrestling Alliance. He is the World Heavyweight Champion. He weighs in at 242 pounds from Minneapolis, Minnesota. Here is the nature boy himself, Ric Flair, the World Champion. The referee for this title match, Ron Rick. One fall, television time remaining.
The NWA World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair, now taking off that ostrich-plumed robe and handing it outside to Mike Jackson. Ric Flair with the NWA World Heavyweight Championship belt around his midriff. This match is one fall. Technically, with a one-hour time limit, ring announcer mentioned television time remaining. That part is true. We will bring you this match in its entirety, depending on the time. The champion caught the bullet, and it looked like it was a little bit low. Champion had chopped into the throat of the bullet. In the event this match goes beyond our television time, we will bring you the balance of the match next week here on Continental Championship Wrestling. Snapmare by Flair. The bullet powers out. Flair, the champion, very much in control. Rass is down with that knee. And a serious turn of events here for the challenger, the Bullet. Deep double underhook. Flair trying a bit early, in my estimation, for that pinfall. Can't blame the champion, however. Stop into the throat. Another stop into the throat. The bullet fires back. And we got up here. Six are going here. And the bullet now exploded. The champion is down. Champion coming up rather slowly, and the bullet catches him once again. High backdrop by the bullet. Catches him a hard right hand to the side of the jaw. Flair is down. Flair now making his home in Charlotte, North Carolina. Went to the University of Minnesota. Flair rolling away from a backside. A series of hard right hands that rocked the champion. And it was the champion catching the challenger in the midsection. Stops away again, and it's the bullet firing back. And Flair in trouble. Those eyes crossed the color of the canvas. The bullet, should he win this title, would become the first masked man ever to win the World Heavyweight Championship. And again, Flair rolls away from it. The bullet connects with a hard right hand. almost impaled on that far ring post. And the Bullet now delivering some boots to the midsection. Flair having his problem. Flair back to his feet. Flair catches the Bullet. Catches him once again. And once again he catches him. The Bullet could be in trouble here. Flair with a side headlock. The Bullet fires him off. Flair catches him with a good shoulder smash. The Bullet is in behind him. Rolling reverse and a good saddle rock. Broken up. The Bullet catches him at the belt line. The Bullet catches him under the chin. He drives the knee to the midsection. By the way, in the event that we have to cut away for a commercial break, I can assure you of one thing. Our camera crews will continue rolling, and we will bring you a pinfall or submission hold should it occur during a commercial break. However, we will bring you this match in its entirety. The Bullet fired outside the ring. The Bullet coming up very, very slowly now. And it's Flair bringing him up. Five. Hey, vertical suplex, but he broke it up. Got him. Flair had his foot outside the rope. Wait a minute, the referee didn't catch it. The referee didn't see it. He's got a new world champion. No, wait a minute. He's got a figure four on him. He's got a figure four on Ric Flair. The Bullet has a figure four on Ric Flair. And there's nowhere for Flair to go. There's nowhere for him to go. He got that shoulder off just barely in time. But Flair desperately reaching for those ring ropes. Flair desperately reaching for the ring rope. Again, the referee down there checking those shoulders. I'll tell you what, did a pinfall or a submission all occur while we're away for this commercial break? We'll bring it to you on instant replay, but right now, we'll break away for this commercial message.
Because we do have some things we need to look at. Frankly, as far as I'm concerned, and I think all of you here tonight join me in saying, this is indeed the uncrowned world heavyweight champion, the Bullet.
And I appreciate that, Gordon. You know, this man, El Fuego, came in here and twice cost me a fair shot at the world heavyweight champion, Ric Flair, but I got good news. I got a special telegram from Bob Goggle. He said, Bullet, you'll have a return match within 30 days. Only this time. Only this time. There'll be no time limit and no interference. Anybody interfering in my next match with Flair would be suspended from the NWA, as Bob Geiger put it, indefinitely.
That's the fact. And here it is now. That's the fact. Before this program is over, the Bullet and El Fuego will meet in the ring.
That's exactly right. We'll take care of one problem at a time. I'm going to get him out of my hair, and then we're going to take a look at Nature Boy. And you got a film right here that will show exactly what happened in my match right here on TV last week with the Nature Boy.
Exactly. So I'll tell you what, let's do right now. Let's go to that videotape. You'll see what we're talking about. And I'm going to ask the Bullet to bring us that action as it occurred. You'll see what we're talking about.
So right here, Gordon, you can see I got the 1-2-3. I thought I was a world champion. The referee came and told me there was some kind of discrepancy. It seems that Nature Boy Ric Flair's foot was about 6 inches underneath the rope. Well, I wasn't going to take no chances. I pulled him to the middle of the ring, put that figure four scissors on him, and he ain't going nowhere. He's in the middle of the ring. He's fighting. He's reaching for ropes. He's doing everything he can do, but he ain't going nowhere, as you can see on this film. Finally, he just lays back and lays his shoulders down, almost got a three count on him. Now, you know this figure four hold. A man can't stand that over 30 seconds to a minute. he's going to have to give up. I've had it put on me. I know about the figure four. Believe me, the bullet knows what pain you have to go through. And no living man, world champion or not, can stand this for long. Now, you see, he's reaching for the rope. I had to get a little leverage. He's right in the middle of the ring. And when you hook a man in the middle of the ring, he ain't going nowhere. And you can see he's laying flat there, just hollering, Uncle Calf Rope. He wants to give up so bad, but he sees that 22 pounds of gold in his eyes. But the bullet had him. I had him locked in. And in just a minute, you're going to see the reason that I didn't become world champion right here on Continental Championship Wrestling. See, Flair's just, he's just leaning back now, trying to relieve the pressure, can't get the rope. He's got about two inches, I guess, to hit the rope. Here comes El Fuego. This time I was waiting on him, brother, and I'm going to try to pull that mask off right here. I'm jerking on the mask, and here comes Nature Boy, the good backstabber that he is, and cross my running life right there. Now, they're going to try to put a stop to the bullet right here, but I ducked, and I hooked the sleeper. That my good friend Bob Armstrong called me. I had the sleeper on him. Here comes El Fuego. All heck broke loose at this amount of time. It's just probably time you're looking at right here. And thank goodness I had some friends also that were watching the action today. You can go, Ric Flair takes the title. That's good enough for that. I just want to thank everybody for following the bullet, being behind me. And I'm going to tell you this, brother, when we get Ric Flair back this time,